Welcome to Gear Talk. Here we are in Kingsville, Ontario, once again with a dear friend that came all the way from Toronto on the famous 401 highway today to be with us here at Quantum Sound Studios. And we're going to talk a little bit about her gear. She just recorded a wonderful session with us, and I fell in love with her guitar right away, as well as her singing. And her guitar playing was very nice. But a lot of the fun of owning guitars is talking about them. And you have brought one of your favorite guitars, so tell us a little bit about it, where you met it, how it became yours.
Sounds like a relationship starting.
Well, it is.
Sure is. Well, this is a Godin. It's called a Multiac, and it's an incredibly unique guitar, as you can see. It's kind of a bit of a classical guitar. It's got nylon strings, which makes it very much like a classical guitar.
Lovely.
A little bit wider neck, but it's also an electric guitar. So I have it attached to all these great toys and instruments, which makes it more fun, I think, than the usual classical guitar. However, the style that I play is very classical, lots of picking. So it feels good, sounds good. How did we meet? It's actually a friend of mine who's a great guitarist, and he lent me his Godin Multiac for about a month or so, enough to fall in love.
You were done.
And then he took it back. That was one of the saddest days of my life. And a little while later, I tried a couple of, you know, regular acoustic guitars, and I just kept thinking about this guitar. Nothing was like it. So a little while later, I bit the bullet, and I ordered one online, and in the beautiful sunburst color, and it just, there's nothing like it. I went to try, you know, all kinds. I went in one of those booths where you try all the guitars, and I tried, you know, $3,000 Gibsons and, you know, all kinds of great guitars, and this was the right one for me. It's just,
it's wonderful. It's a nice thin body, very much
it
like
is.
An electric guitar as far as thickness goes, and it has the, like, the capabilities of doing so much more. The pedal that you're using here is a Roland GR33, and that sounded fantastic on your session. You had some wonderful orchestration, and they're all in tune. They're wonderful
they
players.
They are, and they're very cheap to pay as well on their
own.
That's
wonderful.
So.
One payment, and they're with you for the rest of the show.
That's right.
Yeah, that's great.
Yep, exactly. Yes, well, this guitar has the GK pickup, which is a very special pickup, which makes it kind of like a synthesizer, like most people are used to keyboard synthesizers. But this one, I play like a guitar, and I can make it sound like, oh gosh, there's probably hundreds of sounds in there. But one that I like is the string section. It really fills things up nice when you're playing as a solo artist. It's really nice to have something like that.
Wonderful. You know, there are no drums in this, are there?
There are drums.
Oh, you can have drums too.
There
okay.
are drums. There's a piano. Another one that I use when I play in, you know, maybe breweries and stuff, I put a rock organ.
Oh, that would be
there.
Nice.
Yeah. And that sounds really cool.
Like the drawbar style.
Yeah.
That would sound fantastic.
Yeah.
I also noticed you have a Helicon harmonizer. So that's your backing vocals?
It is. Yep. I got my choir and I got my orchestra.
That's wonderful.
So the TC Helicon I've had for quite a while, and I love it because I love harmonies, but I play solo all the time. So it's nice. It also uses the notes from the guitar, and takes my voice and splits it into multiple harmonies.
That's
so it's
fantastic.
Actually my voice multiple times that you hear live.
And so you're not only playing the guitar, but you're stomping away on your on and off and
different
things.
I am. I'm kind of dancing when I play because there's all these.
Well, that's nice. That's part of the show.
Yes,
so it's
exactly.
Really nice. At home, we talked a little bit about guitar collections. You're starting to become a collector. So do you have a few others that sit around?
Well, I have my first guitar, which, you know, you can never get rid of.
Right. What
it's
is it?
Got blood inside, and it's, you know, scratches and dents and all that. That's my old beater. It's a Norman.
Oh, very nice.
A beautiful Norman that's changed and shifted because of the, it's all natural wood. So I'm going to keep that one forever.
Was it a steel string or a nylon string?
It was a steel string.
Steel string.
It still
okay.
is a steel string,
Did you start with nylon as a classical player, or?
I actually did. My very first guitar was a nylon classical guitar.
Very good. I can tell by your finger style playing that you have some classical in you. It's very lovely.
Yes, thank you.
Yes.
Yeah. And then we were just talking about the Art and Luthery ME, which I bought. It's a tiny parlor size guitar. So I think they call it a 3/4.
Yeah.
And I wish I had it here because I bring it to shows and I tell people about the story about these guitars. They say that they had these guitars, I think it was the late 19th century, early 20th century, where they had these guitars. And one of the reasons they had these little guitars was because women could play them. And I pick up this little guitar, and of course me, I'm 6'3", and I go like this, and he's like, do you think I could reach this guitar?
And, that's really good.
But I got it for traveling. We go down to Mexico and play there, and I thought it'd be easier to sneak into the plane.
Very good. And do you have a pickup in that one, too?
I do.
Yeah. So did it come with a pickup, or you added it after?
It came with the pickup.
That's nice. I'm looking at some of the new ones that they have right now called the Legacy Series from Art and Luthery, also part of Godin. And I just picked up one, and it's a beautiful little guitar.
Yes.
And I'm now looking at a Parlour. That'll be the next one.
Yes. Yeah. Well, it's a good travel guitar.
Yeah. Well, thank you for coming and sharing your music with us and your instruments and this pedalboard things. I'm going to have to try this later. This is so exciting.
It's fun.
I'm Dale Butler with Gear Talk. Thank you, Nicole, for coming down to Kingsville all the way from Toronto and sharing your Gear Talk with us. It's been wonderful.
Thank you for having me. It's been great.
Great.